I learned in Indonesia, and then I think the people knows Bali rather than Indonesia, because Bali is the tourism destination in Indonesia. And then Subak, the traditional irrigation system, is one of the cultures in Bali. And then why I try to share my experiences about the Subak system, because since 6 years ago, Subak has acknowledged as the World Cultural Heritage by the UNESCO. So that's why we need to conserve Subak system. But the Subak system has many problems, internal problem and external problem, like the climate change. So I will present my paper about the management of the traditional irrigation system toward the climate change, case of the rice farming in Bali. This is the very common in the economic development. We need to promote the natural resources and human resources to provide more opportunities for all of the economic actors, from the producer to the consumer. There are many agents there, from the producer, in terms of the agricultural development, the producers, the farmers, and then the consumer. There are many agents, there are many industries there to process the product of agriculture. In developing countries, including in Indonesia, the agricultural sector still has the great role, important role in the economic development. Like in Bali also, even though we have the tourism development, but the agriculture sector still has the important role, because from the agriculture generates the income for the farmers, provide the food for the people, and then provide the income also for the state, for the governments, and for the employment. So some people also say about the farmers produce the product for feeding to the urban people. So, but sometimes we forget about the farmers, the one who produce the products. Because in Indonesia, I think in the other developing countries, the condition of the farmers, especially the one who work on the rice cultivation, are still poor. Actually, they the one who produce the production for our food, but they're still poor. There are many problems there also. There are many reasons why they are still poor. About the technology, about the skill of the farmers, like in Bali. And the other reason is the environment. Now we have many reason also about the Subak system in Bali. I will talk about the what is the Subak system. In Bali, all of the farmers who work on the rice farming is managed under the Subak. Subak can be seen as the system, can be seen as the organization. Even though Bali is very small, and the areas of the Bali about 5,000 square kilometers, but the number of the Subak in Bali about 1,600 units. The small Subak, the big Subak. Each Subak has the areas, the interval of the areas, 3 hectares, one Subak, 3 hectares, until about 600 hectares. From the small one, you can imagine if the 3 hectares of the subak. So the member only two farmers. Very small. Because of the land conversion in the city. And then here, when we talk about the subak system, I will talk also about the traditional thing. Since yesterday, we talk about the model, simulation model, but now I just talk about the traditional thing, how the farmers in the subak system manage the water irrigation, starting from the river, flows, distribute, make the allocation of water for each farmers as a member. Here's Bali Island. We have a small island, but we have four lakes. The Balinese, the farmers, believe all of the water coming from this lake. So every year, all of the farmers in Bali will go to this lake. The farmers here in this area will go to this lakes, Batur lakes. Every lake in Bali has one big temple. Because the farmers believe the water coming from the lakes, and then there are the big temple in each lakes. So every year, every full moon in October, they will come here. Sometimes the ritual activities here is coordinated by the governments. But before the government intervention, the subak, inter-subak has the coordination among each other to have the ritual ceremony here. There are four areas here, in this area, and in this one, are acknowledged by the UNESCO, as I said before, to be the World Cultural Heritage. So if we talk about the subak, we talk about the culture. So every activities in the subak system always based on the culture, the tradition. So that's why subak organization has the nature in the social, agriculture, and religious. So the religious aspect makes difference with the other water user association in Indonesia. Because every activity in the subak system, starting from the getting water, land preparation, until harvesting, we have ritual. At least 15 ritual activities conducted by the subak for having the good production, good result. This is the subak system. The organization of the subak, the activities of the subak based on harmony and togetherness. Everything the subak member, the subak do must be in the harmony and togetherness. And the harmony and togetherness here, being the philosophy of subak, we call Tri Hita Karana. Tri is Sri, Hita happiness, and Karana is causes. So Sri causes to be happiness, for making happiness, based on the harmony, togetherness. Even though I get water smaller than the others, as long as I think that one is a harmony, that's okay. That's the philosophy, the concept. What are the three? The number one is a harmony with the God. So that's why the one of the characteristic of the Subak is temple. At least in one Subak, at least in one Subak, there is the one big temple, at least, belong to Subak, within the areas of the Subaks. When the Subak gets the water from the weir, the dam, in Bali also, every dam, we find one temple. That's why in the first one is the harmony with the God. So in the dam, the Subak construct a temple, even though that dam constructed by the government. But the Subak needs temple. And then another one, the temple. Every member of Subak has one temple. If in one Subak consists of 100 members, so there will be 100 individual temple belong to members. So everything we talk about the God. That's the unique system in Bali, in the Subak system. And then the second one, harmony with the environment. The Subak in Bali always think about the environment. But nowadays, it's very difficult for the Subak to conserve the environment, for example, for the land, the soil, and the water. Very, very difficult for the Subak system. Because the canal of the Subak pass through many villages. For example, in this river, the government of the Subak constructed the dam, the small dam, and then the canal pass through many villages. This canal sometimes also is being the drainage of the villagers. So the Subak cannot control. In some cases, the length of the canal of the Subak more than 10 kilometers. Actually, the areas of the Subak only 50 hectares. But the water is coming from a very far area. In the Subak system also, inter-Subak, in the past, every Subak will get the source of water on the river and they make the traditional dam. And then the other Subak will try to get in the upper area on the river to make or to construct another traditional. So there are many, like multiple canal in the village. Because they try to get source and source and source on the river. After the government intervention, the government make 5 traditional dam or 3 traditional dam become one concrete one, the big one. So the government will arrange to make the division structure to distribute water to its Subak. In the relation to the environment, in the past also, Subak never use the chemical fertilizer, pesticide. They always use the organic. But because of the government program, I think not only in Indonesia, it is the green revolution. So every farmers at the time in 1960s, 70s, the government introduced the new technology to use the new variety, fertilizer, pesticide, many things, just to achieve the self-sufficient of the rice. And in the era of the Suharto president, in 1984, the government successful to get the rice self-sufficient. But in 1990s, become decrease. And then until now, our country import rice. Actually, we have millions hectares of rice. I think this year, our government already planned to import rice from the Vietnam, Thailand, including India. We import. So that's the problem there. For the technology or any subak system. Sometimes subak cannot stand because the external pressure. Subak is the autonomy organization, but in terms of the traditional. So it's very difficult for the farmers, for the subak, to conserve the environment issues now. Very, very difficult. And then the harmony with the others. So I will talk about the how the members of the subak sit together based on the harmony and togetherness to make the consensus in terms of water distribution and water allocation. If we think about the technical calculation, for example, I have 1 hectare of land, and then you have 3 hectare of land, but the allocation of water sometimes is the same. Actually, no. Because you have 3 hectare, I have 1. But in the subak system, the same portion. According to the culture, if I have 1 taktak, that is the local term, 1 taktak is the water allocation. If I get 1 portion, so if there is the rehabilitation of the irrigation facilities, I will contribute 1. But if you get 3 portion, so you will contribute 3 portion for the cash money, for the labor, for everything. So there's the proportional system, proportional contribution there. Why 1 hectare and 3 hectare get the same or similar portion? Because they have the experience based on the structure of the soil, the location of the land. For example, in the river and then the canal, near the canal can get maybe half portion, enough. And then the other one can get 1. But sometimes the 1 land very far from the canal sometimes get half also. Because this land will get water from the upper land. So based on the experience of the farmers, so not necessary you get more. Half already enough for you. So it's very difficult if we talk about the mathematical measurement. Why you get half, even though your land is very far? That is dependent on the consensus of the subak, dependent of the experiences of the subak. That's why when the government makes the intervention in the design of the subak system, firstly, there's the consultant from the Italy and Korea, South Korea, make the design. And then when I introduce, bring that design to the farmers reject it. No, not like this. So the government thinks, follow the design of subak. Because it makes us confused if we compare between the measurements of the subak and the government. Only in Bali. And then at the tertiary level, at the farm level. But in the main system, the government can use mathematical measurements. And then here also the, we talk about the borrowing water. In this term, borrowing water, when I need the water, I will come to the other farmers. I ask him, I want to borrow your rights of the water for 24 hours. When I have the consensus, and then we agree, I talk with the chairman of the subak. I already talk with Mr. A, and then I will borrow the water for 24 hours. It's very simple. So I just close the inlet by using stone or garbage for 24 hours. But I make the sign there. If I do not make the sign when I put the stone at the inlet, so the other farmers will say, ah, you are still in the water. That is the consensus of the farmers. So there's the sign, maybe just put one leaf, branch of leaves is enough, just to make information for the people. Already approved by the one who has the right of the water. That is the borrowing. So this one is very unique also, because in Adaras, when we borrow the water, we have to pay. But here, not necessary to pay, but we will give our rights, dependent on the members. This is the simple organizational structure of the subak. Head of subak, and then treasurer, secretary, and then head of sub-subak. If the subaks, I think, more than 80 or more than 50 hectares, sometimes there are sub-subaks. So in sub-subak, there's the heads also. The function is similar, but only the cover. And subak will cover all of the sub-subak, and then the head of sub-subak only manage internal sub-subak. So there is the coordination here among the head of subak if there is the water borrowing, if there is the ritual activities, because the ritual activities will be in the sub-subak level and in the subak level. And then for the members, we have three kind of members of the subak. Active member, passive member, and the other one is the specific member. The active member is all of the farmers who work directly on the irrigation system, on the farming activities, active. Every day there. But the passive member, not there. But I have to pay for the subak. Because I have no time to participate in every activity in the subak. So I have to pay. But the specific member, for example, I am the priest, I am a farmer, so not necessary to work, to participate in every activity, but I have to conduct the ritual ceremony. If you talk about the ceremony, the subak system is very, very complicated. I will talk later. This is the main activities of the subak, water allocation and distribution. This is the unique system also, by using the experiences, the traditional system, the portion, how to divide the portion of water to each member, and then resources mobilization for operation and maintenance, fundraising, conflict solution, and ritual activities. In the ritual activities, as I said, at least 15 kind of the ritual activities and the subak system. In case of the pest and disease attacks, first the farmers, the subak will talk with the government official how to control the pest. But if the subak, the farmers, and the government official already work on the pest control, and then the result is still zero, so the subak will go to the temple. Like in some areas, when the subak, the farmers, the rice are being attacked by the pest, they go to the temple, they go to the priest, and then the priest was carried by the member of the subak to go around to the rice field and then spread the holy water. The pest disappear. It's very difficult to believe, but that one is the reality. Cannot we justify in terms of the scientific? It's the ritual. This is the. I just want to see here about the canal here. This is the canal, you know, very narrow here. And then when the subak want to make the distribution of the water here, the subak will make the wider canal here. If we compare with here, actually it's small. And then every division structure here, the subak will make wider canal. So the inlet here and here will make wider here, because if still small here, so the inlet will be, I think, about 2 centimeters. If there is a garbage, the inlet will close here. So like this, the same as in the other subak here. Narrow, and then here make it wider. This is the traditional system. The government system always makes a tertiary box. But the farmers in Bali, the subak, do not like the box. Because in the box, when the water comes, it's the, in the direct and then in the right, and the left. According to the farmers, that is not equal, because the farmers makes the verification test by using the leaf. When the water small, the flow of the water is very slow, they put the leaf, and then the leaf will go directly, not to left or right side. That is the Sumbak system. So the government in Bali do not construct the tertiary box. But in other islands, still tertiary box, because that is makes the every time the farmers should dig the sedimentation there. So waste the time according to the farmers. This is a temple, one of the temple in the lake. I don't know, Professor Oruk? Yes. Here, every year, the farmers will come here. We believe here, and then this is the, in the Subak, this is in every member. So every member has one small temple. The material of the temples is different, dependent on the farmers. If I'm poor, not necessary to have the concrete temple, maybe by using the bamboo, because we believe the God is there. Even though this one is using the concrete, bamboo, or the other wood, because we cannot use any wood, only specific wood can be used for the temple. According to the Subak also, when we have the temple here, so the God will protect the land. If a farmer wants to steal the water, will think, oh, there's the God there. So don't steal water. Now, Dewi Sri is here. Dewi Sri is here. Dewi Sri is the fertility God, we believe. And that's the joke in Bali, when we have the good Subak, in the past we have Dewi Sri, and then now, because of the land conversion, urbanization, so not Dewi Sri is there, but Miss Sri. Because of Miss Sri there, not Dewi Sri. That is the joke in Bali. So this is the problem. Scarcity of irrigation water. I cannot think the water on the river, and then we have the land conversion. Actually, if the land become decrease, so we have much more water. But in reality, the water on the river became small. So this is the problem. I talked with the professor about the forest, upstream area. Maybe deforestation, the change of the land use. Firstly, the people at the forest planted the trees because of the economic pressure. The people cut and then changed to the cash crop, like flower. Because in Bali, when the people plant the flowers, it's very easy to get money. Very easy. Every day, the Balinese people every day. So now on the rice field also, in some areas they change the crops, not rice but flour. Planting the flour, 3 weeks already get money every day. Because if the farmers has 20 hectare, or 20 or not, 0.2 hectare in one plot, for example, in a small plot, in a small plot, plant here the flowers, flowers every day. Because every easy also to sell to the market. Because of the religion. So the flowers. And then the water use competition. Here. We have the, now we have the competition of the water in Bali. Bali is very small. The water is scarce. But the competitor of the farmers being more and more. The industry, hotel, restaurant, the services for the many industry also. For example, the hotel need a lot of water for the swimming pool, for their gardens, the room, many. And then another competitor is the government. So the government is the competitor of the Subak, because the government need a water for domestic use. I think last month there's the conflict between the Subak and government, because the government takes water for domestic use. Because of the scarcity of the water on the river, the Subak complained. Why you take water again? The government said, I take this water for you, for your drink. So our regulation, regulation in that national level, the main priority of the water use for the domestic use. So the farmers, the Subak, always lost in this competition. Always lost. And then we have the pest and disease attacks. I think this is very common also, because the farmers work on the open environment, is very prone to the pest and disease attack. Even though the farmers already follow the recommendation of the government, but the pest, the insect cannot friendly to discuss with the people. Hi, insect, don't come to my rice field. It's very difficult for that one. Even though we give the forbidden thing. And the land conversion because of the tourism development. Within 1993 to 2003 in Denpasar city, we lost 3 subaks because of the construction, for the building, for the housing, for the main road. So 3 subak. Firstly, we have 45 subak in the Denpasar city, and then now we have 42 because of the land conversion. So it relates to the what cultural heritage, what we have to do for this situation. And then some alternative solution for the scarcity of water. The farmers, the Subak, has the planting schedule, has the cropping pattern, and then I just want to say here how the Subak organization manage the planting season, planting schedule. Because we think about the gap, so the Subak, all of the Subak in Bali always learn from the Balinese calendar. There is the best day for planting, when the farmers must plant within a week. So, and that if the farmers plant beyond the best day, there will be sanction. the very difficult thing also to arrange the availability of the water. Okay, thank you. Just want to the government to have the likes the mapping for the water availability starting from the forest. I don't know, by using the model, simulation model, when for example 1 hectare of the forest cut by the people, what the impact of the water storage, water availability on the river, sedimentation on the river. So I need about this one. There's the simulation for that one. And then combine with the rainfall based on the previous data. So what the government has when they have the simulation must be disseminated to the subak, so the subak can have the plan when they will plant the rice, the secondary crops. But until now, there is no research about that one. This is very important. Water use competition is the same. We need also, there is the water balance every year, and then we have to think about the population, the growth of population, because the government will always think about the population, will think about the tourists, because every year about 7 to 8 million tourists come to Bali. Actually, the population of Bali only 4.5 million. But the tourists, nearly 8 billion. All of the people need water. So it should be better, there's the model, the simulation model also, to have the good allocation of water for the domestic use, for the industry, for the hotel, and for the farmers, if we want to conserve of the irrigation system, subak. Yes, and this is, I think there was the research, I think Professor Orop, you know the Stephen Lansing. Yeah, I think Stephen Lansing has the research about the pest and disease distribution from the upstream to downstream. But the result of the research cannot be distributed, disseminated to the farmers. That is very important for the farmers about the intensity of the pest and disease attacks. And this is the last one for the land conversion. This is a very, very funny also, because we have the regulation. In this area, we cannot change the function of the land, but the government sometimes the one who break the rule. Like in Denpasar, in Badung, the government makes the offices and then need about nearly 600 hectares. The government use the productive land. That is the government. So what we have thing now is how to mix the model, simulation model, to have the good water balance in Bali. Thank you very much.
Quick question. So the question is more actually for you, but also for two because we sort of, there's a Latin village accent issue. By the way, that reminds me, Om Swastiastu.
Om Swastiastu.
This is the welcome, the family is welcome from all of us here. Thank you for coming. But many of these problems here are not that different from what we see in India, or what we have seen, what we see now. And in some cases, there may be some sensor data available. In some cases, maybe some, you know, more sensing data available. I know that Hyderabad was using drones and things like that. So, see, from US or Europe, it's a bit harder to translate what happens here to here. Some of us can relate to what happens. Yeah. It's hard. But here, between what, you know, these water guys are doing here in India and the problems you have there, why is there not a stronger collaboration?
Yeah. This is good for me, I think not for me, but for Balinese also, how to have a good collaboration of research, and then what we have, what we get, the result of the research can be useful for the people, for the farmers, and for the governments also.
So Abhijit is junior, he's senior, so I cannot volunteer.
Yes.
Abhijit to go to Bali.
Yes. That's okay.
So I suppose that it's always possible to have a one-to-one collaboration and, you know, like human and working, things like that. However, like if you have to have an institution-to-institution kind of thing, or as a nation-to-nation, it has to come from the government level. And, you know, so far my knowledge, working in the government, you know, things goes really ad hoc basis. You know, there are ones that can, one minister would be very inappropriate, very forward-looking, and they do something. As soon as the leader or, you know, change the shape, you know, the whole thing disappears. So far, to my knowledge, at the government level, at the national government level, there is no such scheme, you know, to have like an integrated system where you can have collaboration, even within the country itself. Because we have a federal structure, we have the state-to-country relationships. So, you know, like, I think they're still evolving, and the good sign is, like, I think many people are thinking this way. So maybe not now, but in, you know, in the next 5 years or so, there's a good possibility. I know India is just signed some MOU with Israel on water management, mostly in dry areas. So a lot of my Israeli friends who I've worked long than that, they are in touch with me to, you know, they want to come here and show us some water treatment facilities and things like that. So I think the flow has started, but it has not yet taken the momentum that it should have.
So from Indonesian side, I mean, his colleague in Jakarta, whom we know very well, Kamal, he was supposed to come. There was something happened at the last minute with his boss. His boss happens to be one of his bosses. One of his bosses is just his department chairman and stuff. But his other boss is the president of the Republic of Indonesia. So he has changed to pull from that side. So if you can make things happen at an IIT, Institute of National Importance, I'm sure you have something. We could start
something. You know, yeah, absolutely. Bali is a wonderful place. Yeah. 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 Very short. Sir, I'd be grateful in case you could work out a sustainable plan, which is not too volatile, it's just not too various, in which, where, what is the strength of the system, and what is the kind of, if you do this collaboration, what is that change things in India. So you have to bring out that sense out. Why should it be done? And how will it make a measurable change on ground? If you are able to bring that out in just 1.5 pages, nobody's got the patience in GOI to read beyond the second page, more and more change. So just put it there, if you make some flowchart or whatever the way you want to describe it, and mail it through IIT.
Sure.
I'll see what it can be done. At least I've placed it the right.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Enough.